In general, algorithms that rely on atomics have limited scalability because the atomics limit the amount of parallelism. If we have 100 bins and use atomics to access them, then no matter how awesome a GPU we might have, we're still only doing 100 useful things at a time. Thus, there's interest in algorithms that might be a little bit more complex but might scale better. So we'll look at a reduce-based method next. So let's say we have a large number of items to place into our histogram, but relatively few bins. Now, we're going to consider a pretty small example here for the sake of discussion, just so we can draw everything that we need to. And for the sake of discussion, we're going to say we have 128 items to place into bins. We have 8 threads that we've launched to take care of these items, and we only have 3 bins. So we're going to divide those 128 items among the 8 threads, so each thread will be responsible for 16 items. Now, rather than have only one single set of 3 bins in memory, let's launch 8 threads and give every thread its own set of bins, which we'll call its local histogram. Since we don't have very many bins, we can store each thread's bins in that thread's registers, which are fast. Now we have 16 items per thread, and each thread can independently accumulate its own local histogram in its own registers. So we get 8 separate local histograms, each of which has accumulated 16 items, which isn't particularly useful. What we actually need is one global histogram rather than 8 local histograms. Quick quiz, do we need to use atomics to manage access to these local per-thread histograms? Yes or no?